when my teachers forgot to sit on the bus during our field trip.
The teacher forgot to sit on the bus in the field trip?
Yeah.
Oh boy.
They didn't get hurt though. She went as fast as she could.
Oh, okay. They didn't fall?
Nope.
Alright guys. So spoke with the kids and we have a new challenge. Honey, it's me versus you. You're going down.
Oh boy, what is it?
So it is a cooking challenge. So the kids picked what we have to make for them. So Callie, what are we making for you?
Pizza.
Pizza. So we gotta make pizza for Callie. Ari, what are we making for you?
Mousse.
For yes, dessert. We're gonna make mousse. Not as in we're gonna go hunting and get a mousse and cook a mousse, but mousse as in chocolate mousse or raspberry mousse or fruit mousse.
I want raspberry.
So it is, you want raspberry mousse? So it is a husband versus wife, mom versus pal challenge. There's gonna be a surprise for the winner. Callie, who do you think is gonna win between me and Mao?
Pal.
Pal, that's me. Ari, who do you think is gonna win?
Mao.
Yeah.
She's picking Mao. So guys, the mystery prize is whoever one of us wins, we get a nail salon day. Guys, yes, I get my nails done. My feet are kind of crusty right now. If you see them, please subscribe because I need my nails done bad, y'all. It is bad. Living out here in the cold in Wisconsin does not help your feet. Trust me, it doesn't. And the winning kid that picked the winning parent gets to also go to the spa day for getting the nails done.
Yes.
Sounds good?
Yes.
All right, guys. So this weekend, it is a challenge. Me versus you. You're going down. All right. So we're here. We're going to grab some of the stuff that we need for the challenge. Some pizza stuff. Some stuff for Mousse. I'm sure that Mrs. over here has already Googled recipes for mousse. Guys, I'm doing it from here, so I should get an advantage. I should get a 1-point advantage. ZHC, do I deserve an advantage? And Uncle Roger, she's Asian, so you may want to kind of judge her skills in cooking. Hiya! This woman, she put the white rice with Dawn dish soap. Hiya! There's Ari, or as she wants to be referred to, Dino Chicken Nugget Kid. You're putting her finger in the background. So here we go. We're going to get our stuff. So as she's shopping around, maybe I should cheat and get the pizza that's already made and just throw it on and make it. So guys, she's getting her ingredients and I'm gonna get some secret ingredients. So I'm definitely gonna win this challenge. There's no way she's gonna win. No way. Do you think I'm gonna win?
Yes! All
right. Callie, did you need me to buckle your shoes?
No.
Are you sure?
No. 1, 2, buckle my shoes, 3, 4, 5, 6,
Nike kicks!
Hey y'all, so we finished getting all the stuff we needed for the challenge and we are now at Zesty's eating some incredible custard sundaes, burgers, and cheese curds and stuff. Yeah. There we go, we got a thumbs up there. So we're gonna enjoy this, y'all, and we'll keep this challenge going. Oh, and by the way, guys, there's gonna be an epic fail. I'll take in this, so make sure you're watching and subscribed. Hey kids, we're on our way to Target and did your kids want some Reese's Puffs?
Reese's Puffs!
Reese's Puffs!
Eat them up!
Do you want Reese's Puffs in your bowl?
I just like that on a roll!
Hey y'all, so the competition has begun and I am gonna do a chocolate mousse. Who doesn't like chocolate? So here's the chocolate, then I got my heavy cream, half a cup. I got my water going to put the chocolate on there so that it can melt nice and smooth. and taste delicious.
Alright guys, so as I said, I had a few tricks up my sleeve. Who doesn't like bacon? Listen to that sizzle. Look at that. So satisfying. It seems like she's going with a chocolate mousse, is what it looks like. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna win.
Here we go, guys. The second part of the chocolate mousse, which is the whipped cream part that needs to be folded in. Looks really good. I'm ready to fold it in now.
So for the mousse part, I'm actually gonna make a mango mousse. And what I have here is 1 cup of mangoes. I added just a little bit of sugar and honey just to give it a little bit more of the sweetness. And then we got cream cheese, that's to get it a little thicker, the consistency of the puree to be a little bit better. So again, I'm making the mango mousse. I'm keeping it quiet so the kids don't hear, so they don't skew their votes. All right, so I got the mangoes put into our magic bullet and I'm gonna turn it into a puree now. So here we go. All right, so now I added the cream cheese to it. This is gonna give that puree the consistency we're looking for. So here we go. So now we go with 1 cup of heavy whipping cream. And always make sure that this is in the freezer. That way it's easier to cool and chill. And then we're gonna do a pinch of vanilla extract. That way it gives the extra cream more of that whip flavor. And that's very important. And there's one more important thing always to making whipped cream. Then an important ingredient is always the powdered sugar for making whipped cream because it helps stiffen the whipped cream and it adds just enough sweetness without overdoing the sweetness. So here we go. Now we're gonna mix on medium. And then before you know it, whipped cream. And now that we have those stiff peaks, we are ready to fold in the mango part to make the mango mousse. And the way it works is you don't put the whipped cream into the mangoes. Instead, you put the ingredients into the whipped cream to fold in.
All right, y'all, not gonna lie. I had a hard time with this pizza dough and somehow I stretched it out and it got into a shape of a slice of pizza. So I'm just gonna have to work with it. So this is it so far, and then I'll show you what it looks like before it goes into the oven. Alright y'all, this is what's going into the oven. I didn't do anything special, just gonna be cheese.
A key thing to making pizza dough is always make sure there's some flour laid out already on the board in which you're gonna stretch your pizza. The other thing is, don't use your hands too much, because the moisture in your hands makes the dough retract instead of stretch. So the less you play with it and touch it, the better it is. And that is your tip of the day. Buongiorno e arrivederci. All right, so I am outside and there's a reason why I'm outside is I got my pizza on the grill, guys. The dough, same problem that happened to Stephanie was happening to me. The dough was breaking. When we split the dough, we left it out too long, got too much humidity. So I'm making this cute little pizza. I'll go ahead and give you guys a sneak peek real quick. There it is. That's what I'm making right there. That cute little guy right there. There we go. And even though this is a gas grill, because I haven't been able to set up, I got a piece of wood there. So it gives it that nice wood fire feel. So how are you feeling right now, huh? How are you feeling?
You're cheating.
How are you feeling? I'm not cheating.
I don't know how to barbecue. That's
Advantage Pal. Oh my God. All right, guys, so my pizza's almost done. Next step is I'm gonna get it out of here, let it cool for a little bit before I slice it up. And then after it's sliced up, the next step after that is the taste test and the voting, guys. And remember, you, the subscribers, are gonna get to vote on presentation and what the food looks like. All right, baby, go ahead and try the other one now. And while you're trying that, Ari, yeah. On a scale of 1 to 10, how do you rank pizza number 1?
I don't know.
Come on, 10 being the highest, how do you rank it?
9.5.
Pizza number 2?
Also 9.5.
9.5, oh no, we got a tie so far. Okay, so Callie, while you're chewing, chew with your mouth closed, Goofy. The pizza you're eating now is pizza number 1. So pizza number 1 on a scale from 1 to 10, how do you rank it? 10 being the highest.
3.
A 3?
No! I'm still thinking.
You're still thinking?
3.
No, 1 or 10? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 is the highest.
3.6.
3.6? Alright, and pizza 2 is the first one you tasted.
She doesn't know her numbers. What are you doing?
What do you give it?
3.5.
So pizza number 1 is winning by 0.1. So far, pizza number 1 is winning. So the subscribers, guys, that vote is going to carry the weight of who's going to win this challenge. All right, now that we got to taste each other's pizza, you tasted mine. So on a scale from 1 to 10, how do you rank mine?
10. It was really, really good.
All right, you tasted your own. How do you rank your own?
A 9.
All right. So, I hate to say this, but I kind of agree. Hers is like a 9, 9.5. Looked a little funky. But it definitely tasted really good. So, 9.5 out of 10. And I do give my pizza a 10 out of 10. I have to be honest. That bacon just hit so good. So good.
You can't go wrong with bacon.
No, you can't. All right. But we got one more part. It's the dessert part. It's the mousse part. So as of right now, guys, I am winning by 0.1. Let's see what happens with the mousse. We'll find out. And we are coming to the end of the challenge. It is mousse eating time. So she has started with the chocolate mint mousse with whip. And then next she's going to try the mango mousse with raspberry. All right. So Ari, have you tried them both yet?
Yeah.
Okay. So starting with the mango mousse, on a scale from 1 to 10, how would you rate the mango mousse on a scale from 1 to 10?
9.5.
The mint chocolate mousse. What do you rate it?
I like it. It's textured more like a mousse, although it's hard.
Come on. You gave the mango 9.5.
9.51.
We're tied now. Okay.
I'm going to make it even.
Okay. So now you've tried the chocolate one. Try the mango one. Here we go. All right. So I can't do numbers with you because you don't know your numbers. So which one do you like better? Point. Do you like the mango mousse better or the chocolate mint mousse better? Which one? Say it.
Mango.
Mango mousse better. So far I am winning by a hair. So guys, it is all up to you on who is going to win. We're wrapping up this challenge. Hope you all enjoyed, guys. And we'll see you on the next challenge. Bye, y'all. So how are you feeling? It's up to our subscribers now to let us know who won by the presentation.
I think I got that in the bag.
I kind of think so too. Your presentation's a little nicer, although my pizza was nicer looking than yours. Yes,
had a little struggle there.
All right, so we're going to leave it up to there. We're going to announce the winner, and the winner is going to get a spa day at the nail salon, so manicure, pedicure. If I win, of course, I'm getting the pedicure, and Callie is going to be coming with me because she asked for me.
Paint your toenails pink.
paint my toenails pink? Is that if I lose, I gotta paint them pink and purple?
Sure.
Okay, so if I lose, I gotta paint them pink. I shouldn't say that because now people are gonna vote against me. Just so I can paint. No! Don't vote against me. All right, everyone, make sure you're subscribed. Comment down below if you enjoyed this and what you enjoyed most. And we'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.